The other week I was at work and a young teacher came up to me afterwards and said, "How did you do that?" And I went, "How did I do what?" She said, "How did you hook everything up to your phone and do your lesson through your phone?" And I went, "Oh, you want to know how I hooked up my phone to the smart board?" She's like, "Yes." And so then I proceeded to teach her how to do it. And then she called in another teacher and said, "Look at this, look at this." And she was all excited. You'd think I just taught her a new party trick. And I thought, wow, if there's young people who don't know how to do this, then possibly there are other people who don't know how to do this. And it's really simple. So today I'm going to show you how you can hook up your phone to a TV, to a projector, or to a smart board to help you in teaching your lessons. Whenever I go in and teach, whether it be at a college, whether it be at a church, whether it be at a school or a convention center, there are usually two different setups that I know about. And one of the hookups is something called a VGA connection, is one of the connections. The other connection is a HDMI connection. I needed to buy adapters for both of those types of connections. Okay, so let me just turn on my TV. Now let's pretend this is a smart board, or it could be a projector that's from the ceiling and, you know, showing up on a board. What I do is I hook in my little adapter, and I'm going to hook in the HDMI adapter. The thing about HDMI, which is so good, is HDMI actually includes sound. So sound will come through and come out through your system. Whereas VGA, you need a little sound cord, and you know what? My iPhone 8 doesn't have a sound port. So that means if I'm using a VGA connection, I actually have to bring a little portable speaker as well to Bluetooth to my phone. So I've hooked up my phone using the adapter, the HDMI adapter, and then the cord that goes to this TV. And then I take the remote and then I find out, okay, what source? I'm in the number one HDMI source. So if I get this down to HDMI 1, because there's a few HDMIs, something should happen. Yes, look at that. Isn't that cool? There is my phone. Do you see that? Okay. Now if I turn it up like this, look at that. It becomes vertical. There you go. Now what I have to do when I'm teaching a lesson so that I don't get any phone calls and things like that coming through while I'm teaching a lesson is I go straight up into settings and I go into airplane mode. And then that turns off anything that'll happen. I won't have my messages popping through. So that's really important if I'm going to use my phone for lessons or for speaking. So let me just show you one of my apps that I love to use when I'm teaching is I love to use the Bible app here. So if I wanted to teach this story and just use some guided reading through my iBible or my Bible app, then that is a great way of showing it up on the board. Fantastic. I love doing guided reading when I'm teaching kids. Another app that I love to use, this is where I put all my books that I have purchased. A lot of times kids will really enjoy seeing the story through this little app. And so I'll put this up and they love watching it. And it actually can be one of those that is read to them and the pages turn.
Angel said, "Do not be afraid. I bring joyful news to all people. Today in the town of Bethlehem, a Savior has been born. He is lying in a manger."
Now I've done a whole clip on all these different type of Bible apps, so you can watch that in my technology playlist, so I won't spend too much time on that. So that's another way that you can use your phone in teaching the story, and I've got the Jesus Storybook Bible there, you see that on my shelf as well. And the other thing is this Bible for Kids app. So here we go, we've got the Bible for Kids. Now kids love this and they love coming up and interacting with my phone. I get them to come up and touch my phone. Now this won't interact with the smart board. You won't be able to go up on the smart board. It'll interact only from the device or your iPad or whatever you're using and you're connecting up. So this little Bible app kids
Suddenly,
really enjoy.
More angels appear. So many of them that they filled the skies. Praise God in heaven, they all sang. And may everyone who pleases him receive his peace.
So there's another way that you can use your phone to do the story. The other thing that I use is YouTube. Now the thing about YouTube, again, if you need to use the internet, then you have to think about ads. and if they're appropriate, if they come across and you use a video from YouTube. What I have done to make it easy for me is I have bought a subscription to YouTube Premium, and that gives me a way that I have no ads coming on any of my, when I watch YouTube at all, which I love. And the other thing is I can download things offline and I can use them offline, so I don't need the internet to show a clip. So here's some of the things I've downloaded offline. So if we wanted to watch a clip, like what is the gospel? Okay, I can just hit it and we can watch this little clip for part of the lesson.
So Jesus and his disciples, plus lots of other people from all over Israel, headed to Jerusalem to celebrate Passover. Many of them had heard about Jesus, and when he entered Jerusalem, a huge crowd came out.
So that's a way that you can show YouTube clips. The other thing too is you can show lyrics videos that are on YouTube. You might recognize this one.
We are watching the sheep that's gone astray, ba ba di ba ba. Each of us is turned in his own way, ba ba di ba ba. But the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Sing ba ba di ba ba. Isaiah 53:6.
I love that. So there's another way you can show YouTube clips. Now, another way that I like to do lessons is I'll use Keynote to do a lesson or a PowerPoint. And like here's one that I did on the parable of the seeds. I did a little PowerPoint talking about the different soils. And so I can put that on my phone and use that for my lesson. And that works really good if I want to do a little PowerPoint that way. Here's another one that I did when we were talking about baptism. I just showed a little PowerPoint about my son's baptism when his father and grandfather baptized him. And so it really is good to be able to do a little PowerPoint and have it directly on my phone and just put it up on the board. The other thing is if I'm speaking at a training day or something like that, so I can just do my PowerPoint that way. So that's another way you can do it straight off your phone. You don't need your laptop. You don't need to pack it with you. The other way that I like to use my phone is I have put a few lessons, PowerPoints on through Prezi, if you're familiar with that sort of PowerPoint. So here's my little Prezi PowerPoint, and I can show this if I'm teaching on this lesson to my kids using this little PowerPoint through Prezi. So that's another app that I like to use. And the other thing that I like to use is I can just show kids some pictures. And we recently went to the Sea of Galilee, and I also showed them videos of the Sea of Galilee because we were doing a story that took place at the Sea of Galilee. So I was able to actually show them the Sea of Galilee, so they realized this is a real place. So you can use your photos that way, just show it as part of your lessons as well, which I find really helpful. And then I found this latest thing. Let me show you. It's a new app I just found, and I'll show you how you can have a song, and it's like a lyrics video, but you do need Wi-Fi or the internet for this to work. But you can also, I think this one also has a subscription as well. You can pay a monthly subscription and you can download it offline as well.
Jesus is the King of Kings. Jesus rocks the world. Is the Lord our Lord. Jesus rocks the world. He rules the earth, he rules the sky.
Okay, I thought that was a pretty cool app. So that's something you might want to check out as well. The other thing that you need to think about when you're going to use your phone for your lesson and you're being a little bit dependent on technology, I always go in early, whether it be early before lessons or beginning of the year before the term starts. I go in and I try out my technology to make sure it'll work in various rooms that I'm going to be teaching in. That is really important. Don't rock up with your little adapter and expect it all to work. You really need to try it beforehand, or make sure you have a backup lesson in case it doesn't work. And sometimes it doesn't work. I mean, I've done everything possible for technology to win. However, sometimes I've turned up and the TV isn't working, or the projector isn't working. Okay, I can't do anything about that, can I? So I've done everything I can. I've got my speaker. I carry these extra cords with me because I found this year two rooms that I was teaching in there was malfunction in the cords. They were getting all these funny colors on their screen, and I was thinking, what is wrong here? And then I realized they had a very old, faulty cord. So I bring in my own cords as a backup in case the room has faulty cords. And these are really cheap. These come with your computer. They're not expensive at all. I try to take away every variable so that technology can work, but sometimes it doesn't. And that's just kind of how technology is. But it doesn't mean that it can't be a wonderful tool to use in your lessons. There's such good stuff that you can use and put on your device so that you can use for your lesson. It is just so good. A lot of curriculums have videos, they have PowerPoints, everything written into them. And if you learn how to put it onto your phone or your laptop or your tablet, guess what? It's right there, and it's on this big screen that all the kids can see, and it's visual, and kids are really attuned to this. So it's worth giving it a go if you've never tried it. Also, these little adapters are pretty expensive, so make sure you put your name and your phone number on, because I have left mine behind before. And there are different adapters for different phones. I just know what works with the iPhone. And I also have a technology playlist if you want a little bit more information, and there's heaps of tutorials on the internet. So I think that's about it for today. If you have any questions, just put them in the comments below. And if you learned something today, how about giving me a thumbs up and letting me know that you learned something. And if you haven't subscribed yet and you'd like to learn some more, go ahead and subscribe. It's totally free. And once again, thanks so much for watching, and I hope that you enjoyed my little tech talk. See ya.